Welcome to Let's Weld Something. I'm trying to weld something. I'm Bob Moffat, Ram Nation 58. I was just exchanging pleasantries with this weld here. It's one of my least favorite processes, I'm telling you. I've openly admitted that numerous times. However, with the help of Mr. Daniel Fokker, he just happened to leave his book open. His Bible. Bible's put his settings in and everything. But I rolled through here and I found his settings for Fronius AccuPocket Blue Demon 4043 aluminum. So I got curious. Maybe he knows something. He does. I had one of these go pretty well. I'm gonna try to duplicate another one. I'm telling you, this weld owns me. Absolutely owns me, and I'll admit it, but I'm not giving up. I'm telling you. This is extremely beneficial to be able to do. You're making repairs, or you got to do something outside. Got to do something portable. You can't always pull a big truck or whatever your project is. Can't always make a repair. Handrails, sunk in concrete, can't bring them in here in the shop. Got to be able to do them out in the field. And this is where the stick welding comes in play. I've never been able to make it look super pretty. But I had one go a while ago, and I'm kind of jazzed, and I found his settings, so therefore I have to try. Here we go. Well, that little fucker knows something. Daniel Fokker, ladies and gentlemen. Well, it quit on me, and I don't know why, but I'm running off an AccuPocket with low power. I'm gonna try to turn the corner here and keep going. I guess it only likes me to weld 3 inches at a time or something. Because it sure quits. But man, I'm jazzed, I'm telling you. For me to be able to strike up and go is kind of inspired for me. I'm jazzed, I'm telling you. I'm not the best at this at all, but new encouragement here. I don't know why. But it quits. Regardless of whose product it is, of whose electrode it is, I've always had extreme difficulty in feeding it fast enough, moving correctly, striking the arc. I mean, just basic striking the arc. This product seems to restrike and strike very easily. And that's where I'm getting jazzed, and it runs. When I get running, it runs. And this, when I turn the corner, is absolutely too hot. And that's all this heat's transferred out here. But let's look at some of this back here where we started. Maybe it's good and cold. And let me get the huevos off here. I got my huevos picker. Actually, I was going to bend that up, twist it, and send it to Daniel Fokker in appreciation for his leaving his knowledge behind in his Bible. Get off there. You know, if I was making a repair, I could work with that. I really could. That's a little cold to start with. Not being super critical, but that probably could have been up a couple of amps. What was it, 75? 70, is it 70? If I started out on this kind of a piece, putting a patch in, I may have gone to 75, or I will in the future, I'll tell you that. I get down here, the heat transfer, you can tell how the bead widens out. Here was my practice piece. I do have to show you it. I was kind of jazzed. That's why I got encouraged to do a video, show myself in front of the world and embarrass myself. What we got? Yeah, there we go. This was an actual practice piece at those settings, and it is the same material thickness.
How about that?
I mean, I'll take that. You know, I got pretty jazzed about it. Aluminum stick, to me, is just it's a really tough process, but, you know, it's needed. We make repairs all the time. I've done stuff with anodized on hand railings. There's all kinds of applications for it. Tanks, tanker trucks. Anyway, that's a good product right there. Apparently the formulation of that flux in there is, it's a good one. Got the operating amps, DCEP, Blue Demon 4043. Thanks for watching Let's Weld Something. I just welded something. I'll keep practicing, I'll tell you that. We've got some good settings back here. If you don't have a Bible to write your settings down in or something, you might want to pick one of these up. These are highly beneficial for writing your notes. You run across something like this application here or any application, write it down in the Bible because you'll have it. I'll guarantee you, you'll make reference to it somewhere along the line. Spray welds, stick welds, TIG welds, it doesn't matter. There's always tricks to the trade that can be written down. Anyway, thank you, Mr. Falker. Thanks for watching Let's Weld Something. I'm your host, Bob Moffitt. Thank you very much.